the top with $100,000 up in the race. You know I ain't sleeping, you know that I'm with it. I spit right up in his face. Three say that I'm tripping, you know that I'm tripping. I'm wrecking some random. Good evening. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, Wekiva High School welcomes you to Mustang Arena for varsity basketball competition in our final home game of the regular season. Please welcome our guests from Haines City High School. They are the Hornets. And they'll be taking on your Wekiva High School Mustangs. Before we begin our game this evening, we ask that you please stand and remove your hats as we honor America with the singing of our national anthem performed tonight by Wekiva High School chorus students Kyla Jenkins and Jasmine Smith.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous for the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets with faith amongst bursting in it keep proof through the night that our flag was still there.
And now, let's meet the starting lineups for both teams. We'll begin with our guests from Haines City. And we'll start with their point guard, senior number 10, Jason Tisdale. At shooting guard, junior number 24, Amari Campbell. Also at guard, senior number 5, Brian Murat. At forward, junior number 1, Tariq Williams. And finally for the Hornets at center, junior number 32, Elijah McLean. The head coach of the Hornets, Mr. Gregory Pritchett. And now, let's meet the starting lineup for your Wekiva High School Mustangs. Starting at guard, 5'10" junior, number 12, Isaac Lester. At guard, 5'10" senior, number 3, Cheyenne Davis. At guard, 6'3", senior number 34, Dominic Mitchell. At forward, 6'3", senior number 4, Sam Baskett. And finally for the Mustangs, at point guard, 6'2", senior, number 1, Tyrone Perry. The head coach of the Mustangs, Mr. Jacino Lubin, and assistant coaches Charles Hardy II and Rodney Oliver. The officials for tonight's game are from the Central Florida Officials Association here in Orlando. Tonight's game is being webcast live at WekivaMustangs.com. That's WekivaMustangs.com. Again, if you have friends and family back home, whether it's here in Apopka or back in Haines City, let them know right now. You can send them to WekivaMustangs.com, and they can watch live for tonight's game. And good evening to those of you listening online. Welcome to Mustang Arena. My name is Mark Barchi, the voice of the Mustangs. And for the last time of the regular season, I'll be taking you through tonight's game. The Hornets get the opening possession, but they will lose it to a steal. Hornets foul called against number 32, Elijah McClain. That's his first personal foul on the team's first. Tyrone Perry takes it in from the baseline. Perry goes to Mitchell. Mitchell's going to struggle with the ball there. Manages to safely get it to Davis. And he will go to Isaac Laster from Shea Davis, 4-3. And the Mustangs are on the board. Tisdale getting double teamed. Shea Davis. We're going to get a kickball off of Sam Bostic. Hornets still struggling to penetrate. They'll take a long pass. It's reeled in by Amari Campbell. Campbell drives to the paint. Gets stopped by Davis. And it's going to get fumbled. Nearly lost out of bounds. Prior to the shot, Mustangs foul called against Sam Bostic. That's his first personal foul on the team's first. Out of bounds, Mustangs ball. And so Campbell will let the ball go out of bounds, not quite aware of his position on the court. He steps on the end line, and Wekiva gets another possession. Perry for three. It's a little bit off the mark, and the rebound goes to McClain. Jumper for Campbell. That's not going to go. Rebounds to Davis. Laster gets to the end line. Mitchell can't control the layup. Tries for a putback. Can't get that to go either. Isaac Laster with yet a third opportunity. That still doesn't go. And McClain ultimately comes up with the rebound for Haines City. Clearly, his height is going to be a factor tonight in the rebounding game, but the Mustangs able to get three possessions out of that one, not able to convert for any points, though. Elijah McClain on the pass from Jason Tisdale. to put the Hornets on the board. So not a lot of action field goal-wise from either side. Mustangs certainly leading the time of possession stat, though, so far. Perry with a little bunny pass into Dominic Mitchell, who's going to lose the ball, but Perry's there, or excuse me, that's Lasser is there to save him. Spin to the baseline. Sam Bostic is fouled on the attempt. He'll go to the line and shoot two for the Mustangs. The Hornets foul is called against number one, Tariq Williams. That's his first personal foul and the team's second. Bostic misses his first. And I've got to give credit to Haines City's JV team, who is standing in for the fact that they had to travel over an hour to get here. So obviously they don't have as many fans as they would normally have in attendance, as Bostic hits his second there. But the JV team clearly making up for that, making a lot of noise in the stands for their team. Campbell in trouble, manages to get rid of it. Elijah McLean is fouled on the attempt. He'll go to the line and shoot two. Isaac Lasser is called on the push. It's his first personal foul and the team's second. And you saw Tyrone Perry there tapping his chest like, that's my bad. Ultimately, it'll be Lasser who's called with the foul, though. McLean misses his first. Second is also a miss, and Shea Davis gets up there for the rebound. Back to the other end. Shea Davis on the layup. Boy, he paid for that one, but he bought 2 points with it. Rough pass. Murat manages to pull it in, though. Tisdale finds a way through the middle. And it's Tisdale on the pass to Tariq Williams for two. Blaster gets a shot blocked by, that's McLean. McLean also gets the rebound there. Hornets go back to work, trailing by two. It's a 6-4 ball game. 3.5 minutes remaining in the first period. Tyrone Perry gets his paw on it. And yeah, why not? Give him a steal there. Checking into the game for the Hornets, number two, Jeteria Walker. Jeremy Johnson fouled on the way up. He'll go to the line and shoot two for the Mustangs. The foul is called against number one, Tariq Williams. It's his second personal foul and the team's third. Short. Josiah Joseph is into the game for Haines City. Second is a miss as well. Rebounds to Williams. Williams manages to get it into the front court. Shea Davis following him. To the corner. Campbell is going to pause for a long distance basket. That won't go. And it's going to go out of bounds. No Mustang touched it. Mustangs ball checking in for Haines City to hear Williams. So we keep our Williams quota on the court. Balance. One Williams comes off, the other goes on. And Isaac Laster brings the ball into the front court for the Mustangs. Tyrone Perry under duress. Perry draws the foul, but it's on the floor. Foul called against number three, Tahir Williams, on the hold. It's his first and the team's fourth. Bostic short on the jumper. Rebound goes to Joseph, who quickly dumps it off to Campbell. Campbell with a rough pass. Hornets hang on to it from the baseline. It bounces out for Williams, and Jeremy Johnson gets the rebound. Johnson to the other end, goes for three. It's short. Mustangs not able to save it. It'll be a defensive rebound for the Hornets team. Joseph loses the ball to a steal by Isaac Laster. Laster looked like he was going to punch the key himself. Instead, he'll go out to Shea Davis, who's called for traveling. Hornets ball checking into the game for the Mustangs. Kevon Smith, and for the Hornets, Jaden Martinez. And we'll pause for a timeout. Full timeout is requested by Wekiva. Ladies and gentlemen, we remind you that Wekiva is hosting the Girls District Tournament, and it starts tomorrow. It'll be right here at Mustang Arena. The Mustangs' first test will be against the Apopka Blue Darters. That's at 7:30 tomorrow night. A reminder that admission is $6, and only FHSAA State Series passes are accepted because that is a postseason game. If you'd like to come early, though, you can get two for the price of one. At 5:30, we'll have West Orange playing Evans. And again, the Mustangs versus Apopka at 7:30 tomorrow. Smith goes back to Perry. Perry takes the three, a little bit short. Rebound goes to Jason Tisdale, and he's going to get fouled on his way across to the front court. Shea Davis is called on the hold. That's his first personal foul. The team's third, checking into the game for the Mustangs, number 32.
Wait, who's... Oh, that's Tristan, right?
Tristan Bryan. Isaac Laster gets harassed on his way up, but it won't be a call, and it's out of bounds, and the Hornets will get possession here. Up the middle, we've got Tahir Williams fouled on the attempt. He'll go to the line and shoot two. The Mustang foul is called against Tristan Bryant. That's his first personal foul and the team's fourth. Checking into the game for the Hornets. Demetrius Smith and Victor Rios. Okay. Foul is called again, or the basket is good by Jahir Williams.
Missed one, made one, right?
Tyrone Perry on the jump shot for two. Williams goes to the ground, manages to get it off to his teammate, and it's Tahir Williams to Amari Campbell for two. He might have taken a step, but I feel like Williams deserves an assist for that, managing to get rid of it as he went to the ground. Perry misses the jump shot. Rebound goes to the other side with Smith, and we're going to get a foul here on the floor. Mustang's foul is called against Tyrone Perry. That's his first personal foul, the team's fifth. Wide open, Campbell can't get the three to go. Putback made by number 14, Victor Rios. Quickly to the other end. Basket is good by Isaac Laster.
Is that a two or a three? Was it a two or a three? I got to put the points up. And so the Mustangs managed to get back to a one-point ball game as time expires on the first period. 10-11 is the score at the end of the first period. We just had to verify there at the end of the period whether that was in fact
two. Oh. So the Mustangs will go into the break with a 10-11 trail. Thanks to that last basket by Isaac Laster. The Mustangs have the opening possession of the second period. All right, back to live action here at Mustang Arena. Jeremy Johnson is called for traveling. Hornets ball. Jeremy Johnson steals two for the Mustangs. And that'll be a go-ahead basket as Wekiva retakes the lead here early in the second. Out of bounds, Mustangs ball, checking into the game for Haines City. Jason Tisdale and Jeteria Walker. So the Hornets will fritter away back-to-back possessions on turnovers. Mustangs get a chance to go up by a couple more here. Tyrone Perry not able to get the jumper to land. Campbell on the rebound. Campbell swings to Tisdale, tries to get down the baseline, going up against Bryan, and he does. Jason Tisdale for two. So the Hornets back on top in a back-and-forth contest. Perry looked like he might have thought about taking a long-distance shot there, but he thought better of it. Bryant to Johnson. Johnson going to see if he can't get to the paint. I think might have got a piece of that by Mendez there. And we're going to get the favor returned at the other side by Laster. And it's Tyrone Perry for two. Campbell finds a lane, and it's Amari Campbell on the layup. Mustangs cannot be giving away layups quite that easily. That puts the Hornets back on top by one. 15-14, the score at 5:46 left in the half. Johnson to the paint. And on, Jeremy Johnson with the basket and a chance to make it a three-point play. The Hornets foul is called against number 24, Amari Campbell. It's his first personal foul, the team's fifth. Three-point play no good. Tariq Williams gets the rebound. Deflection there by, I believe that was Jeremy Johnson, swats the ball away. Hornets remain in control here. Three-point basket by Jason Tisdale on the pass from Tariq Williams.
Jeremy Johnson got a good look on a layup. It's not going to go for him now. Williams tries to get through the paint. He's going to lose the ball to a steal by Shea Davis.
Shea Davis to Jeremy Johnson for three. Jason Tisdale is fouled on the attempt. He'll go to the line and shoot two. The foul is called against Shea Davis. That's going to be his second personal foul on the team's sixth. Checking into the game for the Mustangs, Jamari Jones. So the Mustangs now have the game all tied up. An opportunity to take the lead here. High pass. Bostic barely manages to pull it in. He's got Williams on his back. Manages to avoid the five count. Get down the baseline. Can't get it to go, though. We're going to have a really long rebound by Kevon Smith, who has to chase it all the way into the backcourt. Elijah McClain got a block there. Jones couldn't get the putback either, and it goes out of bounds off the Mustangs. The Hornets will take over here. 3:43 left in the half.
Hey, I lost your signal.
Williams loses the ball to a steal by Jeremy Johnson. Sam Bostic can't get up there for the dunk, and it's going to go out of bounds off of Bostic. Checking into the game for the Hornets, number two, Jeteria Walker. Tisdale tries to get through, and he's got a jumper. Jason Tisdale through traffic for two. Boy, not a lot you can do about that. Some shots are just going to go in no matter what you do. And the Mustangs will request a timeout. Full timeout called by Wekiva.
feel so close to you right now. It's a force field. I wear my heart up on my sleeve like a big deal. Your love pours down on me, surround me like a waterfall.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, we'd like to remind you that we have lots of basketball action here at Mustang Arena this week. While this is the last regular season home game, the Mustangs have the honor of hosting the postseason tournament for the girls. The district tournament starts tomorrow. 5:30, we'll have West Orange against Evans, and then at 7:30, Wekiva takes on the Apopka Blue Darters. That's tomorrow right here at Mustang Arena. Just a reminder, because that is a postseason event, all tickets are $6. Whether you are a student or not, only FHSAA State Series passes are accepted. And so as we get back to live action here, we welcome to the broadcast Neil Fisher from the Apopka Chief, who's been pulling double duty tonight covering the girls' soccer tournament, and now he is over here joining us for the Mustangs versus the Hornets.
Yes, and again, thank you, Mark. It's been great being a part of the team all season. As you just mentioned, sometimes between the two schools, we have several important games going on, and obviously we can't be in two places at once.
Foul is called against Mustangs, number 33.
Wait, who's 33?
Jaden Battle. It's his first and the team's seventh, and puts the Hornets into bonus.
So, of course, as you mentioned, Mark, we've had a very spirited game so far. From what I've seen, it looks like it's been very competitive, evenly matched. Unfortunately for Haines City, an opportunity to extend that lead, not taken advantage of. And now as we get close to halftime here, Haines City is remaining in a half-court set, a 2-3 zone.
Foul is called against Amari Campbell. That's his second personal foul, the team's sixth.
Oh, thank you. And, of course, also, as you mentioned, Mark, Wekiva has now drawn seven fouls. So opportunity for them to get some extra points here. That's Haines City. Also, at this point, Wekiva is relying on some of their non-starters as well, giving the starters a breath. Opportunity for Wekiva to tie the game, not unable to convert that field goal.
Isaac Laster returns to the game for the Mustangs.
So not much intent there to be able to get inside on that last possession by Wekiva. And now Wekiva, of course, they're in a half-court set. As the ball is inbounded in the front court, they're extending the defense out to the key.
Elijah McLean from Amari Campbell for two. Now that one had to think a little hard about it before it went in. And so the Hornets now on top by four. A couple of unanswered baskets here. Mustangs have had some good looks, but haven't been able to get anything to go all the way in. Laster gets double-teamed. He's going to have to go back to Perry. Takes a long-distance dedication there, but it's a little short. And we're going to go on the floor for it. And we're going to give this rebound to Jaden. We're going to give it to the Hornets. All right. Held ball, possession, Hornets. Returning to the game for the Mustangs, Jeremy Johnson.
So now Wekiva is going with one man in the backcourt here. Now they retreat into man-to-man defense, something we haven't seen a lot of this year.
Well, it works, though. Tisdale unable to convert, but Campbell gets there for the offensive board. Hornets get another chance here.
Yeah, J.J. just couldn't quite come up with that. The ball bounced over him, and into the hands of the Haines City player.
Less than a minute to go here in the half.
A very low scoring game too, Mark.
Yeah, both teams really struggling with their shooting percentage and frankly even getting opportunities to shoot. Amari Campbell is fouled. That was on the floor, but he'll still go to the line to shoot bonus. The foul called against Jeremy Johnson, his first personal foul, the team's eighth. So Campbell is shooting 1-1.
A golden opportunity here for Haines City to not only extend that lead, but again, get some momentum going into halftime. Unable to take advantage of that. Score remains at 23-19, and Wekiva quickly gets the ball down and into their half-court set.
Johnson can't get the three to go. That's going to be out of bounds off the Mustangs. Checking into the game for Haines City, Tahir Williams.
So Wekiva not drawing the favor of the basketball gods here. They've missed four straight field goals, but three of the four have gone out of bounds or been a jump ball, and Wekiva has not gotten the right call.
Nice move there by Isaac Laster. He's fast enough to swat the ball out of bounds, but not fast enough to keep it.
So now Wekiva going to full court pressure here. Not really a trap, it's more of a press here as no one's really doubling up. Haines City doing a nice job, but now they're coming close to the 10th second. They do get away with it.
Jason Tisdale picks up two for the Hornets.
And there, of course, you see the downside of going to full court pressure.
Yeah, nobody left there to guard the lane. Good look for Laster, but the three won't go. Rebounds to McLean, who has five so far. That takes us to halftime, and it's a six-point lead in a very low-scoring contest. 25-19, the Hornets lead headed into the locker rooms.
And so, as we go into halftime, Mark, an 8-0 run there by Haines City has not only put them in front, but given them some breathing room there with a 6-point advantage. Wekiva going cold in the last 3 minutes or so, unable to convert five straight baskets. Field goal attempts, that is.
Ladies and gentlemen, here are your halftime stats. As we get ready to go to break here at Mustang Arena for the last time of the regular season. Return to the Mac. Get on what it is, what it does, what it is, what it isn't. Looking for a better way to get up out of bed instead of getting on the we'll begin with Haines City. Tariq Williams has 2 points, two rebounds, and one assist. Tahir Williams has put up a free throw. He also has an assist. Victor Rios, 2 points, one rebound. Amari Campbell with 4 points, two rebounds, one assist. Elijah McLean, 4 points, five rebounds, and two block shots. All the rest of the points belong to Jason Tisdale. He has 12 points, four rebounds, and two assists for the Hornets in the first half. As for the Mustangs, Sam Bostic has a free throw. Shayon Davis with 2 points, two rebounds, two assists, and one steal. Tyrone Perry with 4 points, three rebounds, and a steal. Isaac Laster with 5 points, three rebounds, two steals, and a blocked shot. And Jeremy Johnson leads his team for the first half with 7 points, one rebound, and two steals. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, we invite you to join us for postseason action. Starting tomorrow, the girls, who are 1 week ahead of the boys, will host the district tournament. And that is coming up again tomorrow, 5:30 for the JV team, or 5:30 for the Evans Trojans against the West Orange Warriors, and 7:30 for the Mustangs against the Blue Darters. For those of you listening online, we're going to take a quick break, and we'll be back here at Mustang Arena in about 7 minutes and 40 seconds.
four-letter word. Make that money, watch it burn.
How do you win in district?
I'm not that old, young, but I'm not that old. And I don't think the world is sold. I'm just doing what we're told. And I feel something so wrong. Doing the right thing.
The Mustangs have the opening possession of the third period. All right, welcome back to Mustang Arena. Mark Barchi, the voice of the Mustangs, here with Neil Fisher from the Apopka Chiefs to take you through the last two quarters of the regular season here at Mustang Arena.
Yeah, and again, Mark, as we mentioned at the end of the first half, 7-0 run by Haines City not only gave them the lead, but it's given them a little bit of a breathing room, a six-point lead.
Tyrone Perry is fouled on the attempt. He'll go to the line and shoot two for the Mustangs. The foul is called against Elijah McLean. That's his second personal foul in the team's first this half.
So with that said, this is a critical possession for Wekiva to break that streak. And again, be able to get some semblance of their game going. And Perry makes both free throws. He did a very nice job of drawing the contact, and now we're seeing full court pressure by Wekiva, same way they ended the first half. Nice pass up there. Smart decision to go over the top.
Yeah, unfortunately, the timing wasn't quite right to get the alley-oop, and he was not able to get the regular basket either, but he gets his own rebound to redeem himself, and the Hornets will get another possession here.
So now Wekiva remaining in man-to-man, as we said in the first half as well. Wekiva's not gone man-to-man much when in a half-court set they rely primarily on a 2-3 zone. I think Coach Lubin's looking to try to give a new look here, shake things up.
Murat can't get the three to go. Rebound to Shea Davis. He'll go unchallenged into the front court.
And Wekiva quickly gets down the court here. That's what they need to do. That's their style. Haines City, in the meantime, is in a 1-2-2 zone.
Isaac Laster to Tyrone Perry, 4-3.
And just like that, Wekiva not only gets the start it needs, but it's cut the lead all the way down to one possession. Momentum is certainly in Wakaiva's favor right now. And they were able to do that with J.J. Jeremy Johnson on the bench. He's getting ready to come back into the game.
Elijah McLean is fouled on the putback attempt. He'll go to the line and shoot two. Foul is called against Mustangs, number 34, Dominic Mitchell. That's his first personal foul and the team's first. Checking into the game for Haines City, number 2, Jeteria Walker. The Mustangs will send in Jeremy Johnson.
So a quick start here to the second half for Wekiva, exactly what they needed. Is that 32 or 22?
32.
And Wekiva catches a break there with the missed free throw.
Yeah, they won't catch it twice, though.
So that puts Wekiva in a position to tie this game or even take the lead. And now Wekiva is slowing the pace down. About a two-man game here between Perry and JJ.
Perry goes to the paint. Wide left. But he gets his own rebound. Jeremy Johnson can't get it to go either. Dominic Mitchell is fouled on the putback attempt. He'll go to the line and shoot two. The foul is called against Elijah McLean. That's his third personal foul, and the team's second this half.
So that is what you would call some grinding, some grind work. They're doing the tough stuff, getting physical. Three offensive rebounds for Wekiva.
Checking into the game for Haines City, number 12, Josiah Joseph.
And now Wekiva returns the favor of the missed free throw. opportunity for Wekiva to tie the ball game is not going to happen. And in fact, they don't even cut into the lead.
That's going to go out of bounds off of Sam Bostic. And so the Hornets will get the ball here. So what was a good possession for Wekiva with a couple of offensive boards will not yield any fruit. But Jeremy Johnson picks off Jason Tisdale, and Jeremy Johnson gets the basket and a chance to make it a three-point play. The foul is called against Hornets number two, Jeteria Walker. It's his first personal foul, and the team's third. Well, that'll turn the tide.
Yeah, and,
momentum.
And there's why you continue with that full court pressure. It might not produce results right away, but it wears on a team.
So Johnson converts the three-point play.
And now Wekiva is on an 8-0 run.
Sam Bostic seals two for the Mustangs. And just like that, they're up three. Quick answer at the other end by Jason Tisdale.
So quick up and down the court there the last couple of possessions. And now Wekiva's going to slow the pace down, much more deliberate here. But Wekiva has done the damage here, taking the lead. They scored the first 8 points of the second half, exactly what they needed, not only to get back into the game, get a rhythm back as far as executing their design and approach, but also to break that momentum that Haines City had.
Tyron Perry, 4-3 from Sam Bostic.
And as you mentioned there, Bostic with the assist. That was a beautiful pass on his part. Inside-outside play, that's Wekiva's staple. And now we're seeing the staple on defense, which is that trapping in the corner. Quick hands get the ball loose.
Tyron Perry picks it off from Brian Burritt there, and we're going to get a foul at the other end. Isaac Laster is fouled on the floor. It'll be Mustangs ball at the end line. Foul called against number 10, Jason Tisdale. That's his first of the team's fourth. Nice inside bounce pass to Johnson, but Johnson's not able to hold it. And he's going to lose the ball to a steal by Brian Murat. And then immediately, the Hornets request a timeout. 30-second timeout called by Haines City. Sam Bostic gets his foot in there, but he'll get called for a kick fall. 4-point lead for the Mustangs as they have turned the tide on the Hornets here in the third quarter. Tariq Williams draws the foul on the attempt. He'll go to the line and shoot two for the Hornets. The Mustangs foul called against number 34, Dominic Mitchell. It's his second personal foul, the team's second.
So it's really been the full court defense which has changed or turned the tide mark. Four turnovers for Haines City. Of course, not only is it a matter of getting the ball back, but that allows Wekiva to get into transition.
So 2-for-2 at the line for Tariq Williams.
And I got to tell you there, that's a nice stroke by Williams. And now Haines City, they've also been in full court defense the entire second half.
Yeah, double teaming Perry there. They trap him, nearly loses the ball, but Jeremy Johnson on a slam dunk for the Mustangs. Good heads-up play by Sam Bostic there. Saw his man open down at the other end of the court, able to set up the play in transition.
Yeah, and you can hear the crowd coming alive here. That's going to help Wekiva get him emotionally high here and sustain it.
Tyrone Perry for three.
And just that quickly, we got a seven-point lead now.
And you can hear the crowd getting into it. Mustang fans on their feet, cheerleaders very active, and we've got less than 3 minutes to go here as the Mustangs have a good run there. We're going to get a foul on the floor. Slow things down just a little bit here. Sam Bostic is called on the hit. That's his second personal foul, the team's third. Checking into the game for Haines City, Elijah McClain.
So, of course, Mark, the signature move was the pass which set up J.J. slam dunk there two possessions ago. But during this run, Wekiva's made some really solid decisions, great decisions. Good passing, getting the ball down the court quickly, but also into open territory where the scorers, the slashers, like J.J. and Tyrone, can do their thing.
Yeah, Neil, that's something you and I have talked about, is something that has been wanting for the Mustangs in the last couple of games, that mental speed, the ability to make those decisions quickly, make the right decision quickly. Checking into the game for Haines City, number three, Tahir Williams. And that is something that in the last few minutes here, the Mustangs have shown an aptitude for that we've been waiting to see all year.
3-point field goal. They're not good again. They got the shot off, but it really wasn't a good look. Off balance. And by the way, that's only the first rebound of the half. First defensive rebound by Haines City.
Yeah, that was Tariq Williams got the rebound there. Walker's a little short on the three. Jeremy Johnson comes up with a rebound. He doesn't have as many minutes tonight as he normally does, but boy, has he made the most of them. Nice pass into Mitchell. And Dominic Mitchell is fouled on the attempt. He'll go to the line and shoot two for the Mustangs. Hornets foul called against number three, Tahir Williams on the hold. It's his second and the team's fifth. Well, I said nice pass. It really wasn't a very nice pass, but it was effective anyway as Dominic Mitchell was able to pull it in and draw the foul.
And after the victory against University last week, a much-needed victory for Wekiva, broke a three-game losing streak, Coach Lubin was very generous in applauding Mitchell for his work. He only played 9 minutes, but he scored 8 points and grabbed 6 rebounds. But more importantly, he really gave the team a lift. And again, seeing it here, critical moments in the game as Wekiva has reestablished a 3-possession lead, and his work is really keeping him focused on keeping that lead. He's doing those little things that allow the lead to be sustained at 3 possessions. So now full court pressure continues from Wekiva.
Foul's called against number one, Tyrone Perry. That's his second personal foul, the team's fourth.
And now Wekiva clears out. I believe this is the first time in this half they have not gone to any type of trapping or pressing. Perry remains with the ball carrier, though. Good job by Haines City to break that press. Good passing. Bad decision there.
Basket by number one, Tyrone Perry.
So taking advantage of that bad decision, obviously the tangible measurement was the turnover, losing the ball in the paint, and Perry picking it up. But it was good defense which set up that turnover in the first place. They're moving into the position and now allowing him to get to the baseline.
And unfortunately, Dominic Mitchell was not able to plant his feet there. Dominic Mitchell called on the block. It's his third personal foul, the team's fifth. because otherwise that surely would have been a charge against Tariq Williams if he'd planted his feet properly. You saw Williams lower the shoulder there. Williams can't get the short jumper to go. Kevon Smith on the rebound. And a bad pass here by Perry will get picked off by Smith. Demetrius Smith steals two for the Hornets. And now we're back to an eight-point lead. It's hard to believe that the Mustangs are still up by eight even after giving up a couple here.
Yeah, well, that was the first turnover bad decision Wekiva's made during this half.
Tyrone Perry on a long two-point jumper from the top of the key.
And again, Perry showing senior leadership, not necessarily for his team, but also in his decision-making. Haines City backed off for just a split second, and he leaned forward into the basket and launched the field goal attempt.
Jeremy Johnson called on his second personal foul with the block. It's the team's sixth at the line, shooting two, Tariq Williams. 0.4 seconds left on the clock.
So, of course, now the advantage that Haines City had is at the line. As you just said, Mark, that's their sixth foul on Wekiva. So Haines City will be in the free throw, or excuse me, in the bonus for the entire fourth quarter. And not only is that important because they have an opportunity to score points, but it gives them an opportunity to slow down the pace.
That takes us to the end of the third period. The Mustangs having a strong showing in the third set of 12 minutes. 42-33, they now lead with 8 minutes left in the ballgame. So we are back to live action here at Mustang Arena.
So, and as we begin the fourth quarter, Wekiva now has gone back to the 2-3 zone. They play that entire third quarter in man-to-man. So first blood here is drawn by Haines City as far as the big play, offensive rebound there, spin move.
Tariq Williams gets the layup for two.
So Williams doing a nice job there of improvising. Again, the straight drive to the lane wasn't there, so he went to 360.
Isaac Lasser picks up two for the Mustangs. Nice move there, found a lane, got through it very quickly. Beautiful movements on the layup.
It took advantage of Haines City letting off the break there. The accelerator for just a split second there. And the lead's back up to 9 points now.
Williams can't get a little short jumper to go from the key, and Jeremy Johnson on the rebound for the Mustangs.
That was a big boy rebound there, a man's rebound by Johnson. He got his shoulder in there and created some space for himself.
Foul's called against number 10, Jason Tisdale. That's his first personal foul, and the team's a second personal foul, the team's sixth.
And as we said before the end of the third quarter there, Mark, Wekiva does have to be careful as far as its foul and free throw situation. Haines City will be shooting free throws the rest of the way.
Timeout, Mustangs. 30-second timeout called by Wekiva. And ladies and gentlemen, we'll take this opportunity once again to remind you that we have postseason games this week and next week. The girls will be playing at home. Tomorrow night, we'll have West Orange versus Evans at 5:30, Wekiva versus Apopka at 7:30. Championship game is Friday at 7. The boys' tournament is at Apopka next week with a similar schedule. Wekiva will play next Wednesday at 5:30 against West Orange at Apopka. And then Apopka will play Evans at 7:30, and then their championship game will be next Friday at 7 o'clock at Apopka. All of those games have a $6 admission charge, and only State Series passes are accepted. Sam Bostick for two.
And that was a beautiful inbound pass there. Of course, Haines City got sucked into the counter direction. Nice rebound there again, creating some space. Couldn't see that when he grabbed the rebound. But before the rebound, he did a nice job of establishing his position.
Jeremy Johnson and one. Fouls called against number 32, Elijah McLean, his fourth personal foul. The team's seventh. Checking into the game for the Hornets, number 33, Jaden Martinez.
So now Wekiva with an opportunity to go up by 16. Again, remember, they were down by 6 points heading into the third quarter. They outscored Haines City 23-8.
No baskets. Violation called against the Mustangs.
So Wekiva was down. Wekiva outscored Haines City 23-8 in that third quarter. And so far this quarter, they've outscored them, well, 6-0. Haines City has yet to convert a field goal.
Block is called against Mustangs number 12, Isaac Laster, his second personal foul. The team's seventh. Tariq Williams will be at the line shooting two. And Coach Lubin didn't like that one. He really wanted a charge.
No, Coach Lubin usually is not a very animated man on the bench, but he was very animated. He came out and was very clear. He let the ref know that that's three times the same call was made, and he disagreed with it. And he's still letting the ref know.
Kevon Smith gets the rebound. His knee the free. Oh, no, never mind. Tariq Williams claims it for the Hornets. You can either call that an offensive rebound or you can call it a defensive rebound and a steal. Either way, the Hornets come up with possession here.
And, of course, now we're at a critical point in the game as the lead's 13 and Wekiva is really having its way.
Kevon Smith to Sam Bostick for a slam dunk. Those are the kind of plays that really will heat up your morale and the crowd. Williams misses the three here. Smith gets the rebound for the Mustangs.
So now Haines City has not been able to really get any penetration. They've had some shots from inside the paint, but all of them have been fadeaways. They're not really able to establish that good squaring up to the shoulder position.
Now, checking into the game for Haines City, Brian Merritt and Jeteria Walker.
And that was the first turnover of the fourth quarter by either team. Again, Wekiva really changed its fortunes there with the turnovers. Only two in the third quarter. Haines City committed six. And that was a big part of them being able to go on a 23-8 run. Or the entire quarter, the score was 23-8. And again, there you see Haines City unable to really get any penetration, having to rely on passing outside. Wekiva doing a good job, too, of getting those offensive rebounds, gaining position underneath the basket.
Johnson got a good look at a jumper fading away, but it won't go. Kevon Smith is there for the offensive rebound. He can't get it to go either. And ultimately, it's Tariq Williams who comes up with the rebound for the Hornets. Rotation around to Murat. He'll take the shot from right where he is. Bounce, 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 no.
And another rebound pulled down by Wekiva.
That's Johnson that was there and ready. Of course, he had all day to get ready for it.
Yes, but he did take advantage of that time. Got himself positioned underneath the basket.
Laster for three, too hot. Martinez on the rebound. Hornets go to work. 3 minutes, 20 seconds remaining in the ballgame. Jason Tisdale gets a basket and a chance to make it a three-point play. The Mustangs foul is called against number zero, Kevon Smith. It's his first personal foul, the team's eighth. Checking into the game for the Mustangs, Dominic Mitchell. So the Mustangs, I mean, and I don't disagree with the call there, but the Mustangs have just not had a lot of luck today getting those charge calls as opposed to blocks. They just haven't been able to get their feet set. Foul is called against number 34, Dominic Mitchell. That's his fourth personal foul, the team's ninth, and it will send Tariq Williams to shoot one-and-one bonus.
So now Haines City will be in the bonus the rest of the way. And again, that's probably the one statistic they can count on to at least keep them close enough to still win. Of course, you have to be able to make the free throws. Wekiva's caught some breaks there with Haines City shooting. They've only shot around 50% for the game. And again, we've mentioned several times is how much of an advantage Wekiva has on the rebounding. They got a 6-2 advantage in the fourth quarter, make that 7-2.
A contested rebound there. Sam Bostic comes up with it. As the Hornets had the first look at it, they just weren't able to pull it down and get up there high enough with both hands. Laster not able to get it to go, but put back. Sam Bostic gets the put back.
Once again, inside work being done there, going up and getting some physical contact to create room.
And Brian Murat puts a little too much mustard on that one. It goes high and long. Jeremy Johnson tries to go coast to coast. Foul is called against number 34, Dominic Mitchell. That's his fifth personal foul, and he will retire from the game with 1.2 rebounds for the Mustangs. Checking in for him is Shea Davis. And Tariq Williams is at the line, shooting double bonus.
So, of course, as we mentioned there at the beginning of this half, Dominic Mitchell came in, played only 9 minutes against University, but scored 8 points and pulled down 6 rebounds in the victory. He's been rewarded the last couple of games with a lot more time. And again, even though he fouled out, he has been big, creating, as you like to say, Mark, a lot of the intangible components.
30-second timeout requested by the Mustangs. 30-second timeout. For those of you who like to listen to our webcasts, we want to make sure that you are aware that during the postseason, we are not able to use the webcasting platform that we normally use, which is free to you, the viewer. We have to use a different one because the rights are owned by the FHSAA. If you go to our website, you can find out more information on how you can subscribe to it. It's just $9.95 for the whole month, and you can follow us throughout the postseason.
So now with the 13-point lead, Wekiva has an opportunity to take some time off the clock. Haines City going to a full-court trap, and Wekiva calmly and with poise breaks the press, three passes exactly the way they should from one side to the other.
Jeremy Johnson draws the foul. Called against number 33, Jaden Martinez. That's his first personal foul.
So the quick passing there by Wekiva set up that foul. They got caught out of position.
7 or 18 fouls. 18 fouls?
Yeah.
Okay, that's what I have too. I don't know why it's on the scoreboard.
So both free throws good, and the lead is back up to 15.
Victor Rios on the putback. So he missed the first putback and then made the second one, so give him a couple of offensive rebounds for that. And then a made basket.
Yeah, and one of the few, probably about three tonight, or in the second half, that Haines City has really taken it to Wekiva under the boards.
Shea Davis from the top of the key for two.
Again, Haines City making the mistake, letting Shea Davis get about half an inch, taking advantage of it.
Jeteria Walker on the pass from Jason Tisdale for three. And the Mustangs will take their final timeout. Full timeout called by Wekiva.
This is my message in the bottle. I hope that you receive it. If it washes up at your feet, then open it and read it. To whom it may concern, insert your name here. It's destiny that we were both born in the same year. 3 months apart, but on the same sphere. Staring at the sun, inhaling the same air.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, we want to make sure that you are aware as we head into the postseason. If you are accustomed to joining us at WekivaMustangs.com or you have friends and family who are, you will continue to be able to do that at any of the games that we host at Wekiva during the postseason. However, they will not be free. If you want to go ahead and subscribe now or get ready to do that tomorrow to start your 30-day membership, you can go ahead and do that. We have the instructions at WekivaMustangs.com. It's just $9.95. That buys you a one-month pass, which should get you through the whole postseason. Again, WekivaMustangs.com.
So with 65 seconds left, Mark, and Wekiva inbounding the ball, holding a 12-point lead, Haines City is going to go to full-court defense here. Not much trapping, but they are going to be relying on pressing, trying to create some turnovers. And I think that timeout was just basically to make sure everybody was on the same page. And now, of course, we're seeing Wekiva understanding the situation of holding a 12-point lead in the final minute, much more deliberate.
Push is called against Victor Rios, his first personal foul. The team's ninth, and it will send Shea Davis to the free throw line.
Of course, forcing Haines City to make a decision there, either foul or let them run the clock down. Obviously, they're going to foul. So, nice stroke there by Davis. Seen some good free throw shooting tonight, Mark.
Yeah, we have. We've certainly had a lot of opportunities for it. Two for two at the line for Davis there. And as long as the Mustangs can keep doing that, this game is going to be out of reach for the Hornets.
Yeah, well, to be honest, with 40 seconds, they've got long odds here to begin with. And Wekiva is actually making it difficult for them to get a shot off.
Putback is made by number 14, Victor Rios.
So even though Haines City got that point, they did take a lot of time off the clock. And now pretty much they're going to have to foul and...
Jeremy Johnson to Kevon Smith for three.
And that should just about do it, Mark.
That takes us to the end of the ball game. The Mustangs finish strong with a 61-46 victory over the Hornets on senior night. Top scorers for the Hornets, Jason Tisdale with 16, and Tariq Williams had 9.7 rebounds. The Mustangs had two players in double figures. Jeremy Johnson, 16 points, 9 rebounds, and 1 assist. Tyrone Perry leads the Mustangs on senior night with 19 points and 4 rebounds. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, we thank you so much for coming out tonight and all season long supporting your Mustang athletes. Again, we congratulate Shay, Jeremy, Dominic, Tyrone, Kevon, and Sam on their senior night honors here at Mustang Arena. We hope that you'll join us tomorrow night. Again, West Orange versus Evans at 5:30, Mustangs versus Apopka at 7:30 as we get the girls' postseason underway. $6 at the door for all tickets, and only FHSAA State Series passes are accepted. Again, we will have a link for you at our Twitter feed at Wekiva Sports, where you will get free photos of tonight's senior night festivities. Again, our thanks to Alex Oliveira from AGO Action Photos taking those photos for us tonight, and he has promised to make them available for free for you to download. That will be at agoactionphotos.com. The password is Wekiva in all lowercase, and again, we'll make sure to tweet that out so that you're aware of it. Follow us on Facebook and Twitter at Wekiva Sports, and bookmark WekivaMustangs.com for all of your scores, schedules, and more. For those of you in the arena, please drive carefully and arrive home safely. Those of you online, Neil and I will be back to wrap things up here at Mustang Arena in just a moment.